So now let's actually put in some more lines of code here. So now I'm going to actually create some objects from these classes that we actually created in this project. Okay. So as you can see here, these are the new lines of code that I actually pasted here. Okay. The first object that I actually created is of type desktop computer, and the name of this object is desktop computer. And here I put an assignment operator, new desktop computer. So here I'm going to instantiate this object by putting this new keyword. And here, as you can see, I need to actually pass in some arguments to the constructor of this class. And the name of our, for example, desktop computer is iMac. And as you can see, the screen is high quality screen, physical keyboard, and physical mouse. And this is the power, this is the CPU power, and this is the RAM, okay? And we have a laptop computer. And as you can see, I am instantiating this laptop computer object, okay? And here we need to actually pass in some values to the constructor of this laptop computer class, MacBook Pro, high quality screen, physical keyboard, and as you can see here, and this laptop actually has a physical mouse. And here, as you can see inside of this laptop computer, inside of the constructor, as you can see, I actually specified that the constructor actually accepts a value of type string, and the name of this argument is mouse. And we can actually create an instance variable for this mouse here, private, okay, and string mouse. And then here I can actually instantiate this mouse here, and here inside of this constructor I can just type in this dot mouse, assignment operator mouse. And now let's actually create a getter and a setter for this mouse instance variable. So inside of this class, click here and then click on generate, and then click on getter and setter mouse, and then click on finish. So as you can see here, we have a getter and a setter for this mouse instance variable. And inside of this, and inside of this toString method, we can actually put in a percent s here, okay, colon percent s. And now after this get touchpad here, I can just put in a comma here, and then I put in two double quotes, and I can just type in mouse, okay, comma get mouse. Okay, so this percent s here is for this string value, and this percent s is for this get mouse here, as you can see here. Okay, this is the method that returns the value of this mouse instance variable. So I forgot to actually create an instance variable for this mouse here. And now let's actually go back inside this main activity.java file here. As you can see, this constructor of this laptop computer, as you can see, MacBook Pro, high quality screen, physical keyboard, physical mouse. This is the value of the CPU power, 2000. And here, as you can see, this is the value of the RAM, 1500. Okay, high quality touchpad. Okay. And as you can see here, smartphone computer. And here I am instantiating this object, iPhone 6S, Retina screen, virtual keyboard, iOS 500, 400. Okay, and we have a tablet computer object, and here as you can see, I am instantiating this object, iPad, as you can see, Retina screen, virtual keyboard, iOS 800, 710. So this 10 is for the screen size, as you can see here. So hopefully that makes sense. And now let's actually output these objects to the screen. So as you can see here, I actually pasted these lines of code here. And now, as you can see, I referred to the name of this object, txt desktop computer performance dot set text performance, as you can see, plus desktop computer. Here I referred to the name of this object, desktop computer dot evaluate performance. So here I am actually calling this method on this object plus a new line character. And again, txt laptop computer performance dot set text performance plus laptop computer dot evaluate performance plus a new line character. TXT smartphone computer performance dot set text performance plus smartphone computer dot evaluate performance plus a new line character. TXT tablet computer performance dot set text performance plus tablet computer dot evaluate performance plus a new line character. So now let's actually run our project and see what happens. Okay. So now, as you can see, our application is running on this emulator. And here, as you can see, desktop computer performance is this value. Laptop computer performance is this value. smartphone computer, as you can see, performance this value, and tablet computer performance this value. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. And now let's actually go back inside this main activity.java file here. And now let's actually put in some other lines of code here. So here I'm going to actually paste in some lines of code here, and then I'm going to explain to you what's going on here. Okay, so here, as you can see, in line 43, I created an array of computer objects. Okay, I just said that we have an array of computers. Okay, but and the size of this array is 4. So this means that this array actually accepts 4 values of type computer object. Okay, but in this line of code, we didn't actually assign any value to this array. Okay, and in line 44, I said that computers sub index 0, as you can see here, this is the index 0, is desktop computer. So I assigned this object desktop computer to the index 0 of this array computer. Okay, and here I said computers sub index 1, as you can see here, assignment operator laptop computer. So I assigned laptop computer to the index number 1 of this computer. And here I actually assigned a smartphone computer object on this to this index 0, to the index number 2 of this computer's array. Okay, and here I assigned tablet computer object to the index number 3 of this computer's array. So remember that we have an array of computers. Okay, we have an array of computer objects. Okay, and because there is actually an is-or relationship between these objects and this computer, for example, as you can see, desktop computer is actually a computer. Okay, laptop computer is a computer, smartphone computer is a computer, and tablet computer is actually a smartphone computer. So because smartphone computer is actually a computer, a tablet computer is also a computer. So that's why we could actually create an array of computers here, and we said that the size of this array is 4, and here we could actually assign these values, these objects, to indexes of this array, which is actually of type computer. Okay, so that's the power of polymorphism in Java. Okay, so now let's actually create a for loop inside of this main activity class here. Okay, and then I'm going to explain to you what's going on here. So as you can see here, this is my for loop. Okay, and here this is actually an enhanced for loop, computer, and here I want to actually iterate over the values that are inside of this array. Okay, for example, this desktop computer, laptop computer, smartphone computer, and tablet computer. And here, as you can see, I created an if statement. If the value of this computer object, as you can see here, this is a variable of type computer, if this value is actually an instance of desktop computer, okay, so here we are iterating over the values that are actually inside of this computer's array. Okay, so if this value computer is actually an instance of this desktop computer, then here we are actually creating an object of type desktop computer. Okay, desktop computer, and the name of this object is current desktop computer, assignment operator, and here we are actually casting this object, this computer object, to a desktop computer. Okay, so, and here in line 54 we said that txt desktop computer dot set text current desktop computer dot toString. Okay, and we have another if statement. If computer is instance of actually laptop computer, okay, if this object is actually of type laptop computer, here again we created another laptop computer object, current laptop computer assignment operator, and here again we are actually casting this object, which is actually of type computer. We are actually downcasting. Okay, we are downcasting means casting an object from a superclass to a subclass. Okay, so this computer actually is actually a superclass of this laptop computer. Okay, so here we could actually downcast this object to a laptop computer and then assign that value to this current laptop computer object. And here in line 58, as you can see, it says txt laptop computer dot set text current laptop computer object, okay, dot toString. So we are actually calling this toString method on this object. And here we have another if statement. If computer is actually an instance of this smartphone computer class, as you can see here, and here we actually create an object from this smartphone computer class, assignment operator, and here we are actually casting this object to a smartphone computer object, as you can see here. And here we set that txt smartphone computer dot set text current smartphone computer dot toString. And here again, we actually created another if statement. If computer is actually an instance of this tablet computer, as you can see here. So here we actually created an object of type tablet computer, current tablet computer, assignment operator. And here we are actually casting this object, this computer object, to a tablet computer. And here we are saying that txt tablet computer dot set text current tablet computer dot toString. Okay. So hopefully that makes sense. And let's actually run our project and see what happens. So as you can see here, our application is running on this emulator. So desktop computer, iMac, high quality screen, physical keyboard, CPU power is this value, RAM this value, performance this value. And we have a laptop computer, MacBook Pro, high quality screen, physical keyboard, touchpad, high quality touchpad, mouse, physical mouse, performance, this value. And we have a smartphone computer, iPad, retina screen, virtual keyboard, CPU power, RAM, screen size, performance. We have a tablet computer, iPad, retina screen, virtual keyboard, CPU power, RAM, screen size, performance. Okay, so hopefully that makes sense. And if you have any questions, please post a discussion in the course and then I'll do my best to answer all of your questions. And thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next tutorial.